things happen. What you can do is just grab your camera, walk outside, take pictures of everything. It can be from here until 9. I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief. Okay, the question is, why street photography? If you look at street photography, and if you want to know what it is, just Google it. Yeah, I'm not going to explain what it is. I'm just going to share some experience with you. Thing is, if you are walking around in your own city, it is easy to take picture, but people don't like being on picture. And if you're on vacation, sometimes in a tourist city, it's also easy to take picture. People like that. They want to be with you on the picture. So it's easy. The thing is, if you're a photographer and most of the time you're looking for content, the best way to get content is just go out there, go in the city, walk on the street, you will see some content. Sometimes in a busy city, there's a lot of things happen. And most of the time when you capture those moments, you have a story in your picture, or if you're a videographer, in your video. And what you need to keep in mind is that most of the time when you create a picture, think about a story. Don't make it complicated. Don't think about, oh, I need to do this. No. Just take pictures. In post-production, you will choose which picture is the best. And most of the time when you see something happen, just take a picture of it. When you see something where you be like, wow, okay, take a picture of it. But sometimes it's something that sometimes it's something that is just normal for you. For you, it can be normal. For someone else that look at the picture from the other side of the screen, it'll be like, hey, I never saw this before. I never think about this situation before. So some normal situation, things that happen every day, take a picture of it. Why is that? If you're planning to sell those pictures online, most of the time companies are looking for things that are normal in their city. And if you take a picture of someone and you have a model release from someone that does the same thing every day, it can help you a lot, because it can help companies that are looking for stories of people that are working in the city or contribute to the city, or people that are poor there on the street. Maybe you can help them say, okay, you know what? You help me, I help you. You sign this model release, I pay for you this, and you take a picture of the person. Because most of the time, every people, every person, every building, everything has a story to tell. But the question is, how are you going to tell the story with your camera? And most people think when they are walking on the street that they need to have a good camera in order to take a picture. No, you don't. Yeah, you can use your phone. You can use whatever you want. Just take a picture. If you don't do anything, you have nothing. In post-production, you can do a lot. You can edit the picture, whatever you want, make it darker, make it lighter, doesn't matter. But what matters is try to put a story in it. Yeah, because if you create a picture with your phone, you have a small lens. I'm going to tell you a little bit about the difference between a phone and a camera. If you have a phone and you have a digital camera, DSLR, yeah? Most people don't realize it's a phone. It has a good camera, but the focus or the sensor in it is really small. While in a normal camera, the sensor, they have a lot of sensor, or sometimes it's big. And that's why most of the time DSLR is good, but the phone is not that good. But if you take a picture when there is a sunny day and the light is, let's say you take it here in a shadow, so here is building, the building creates a shadow, and you are standing here in the shadow and taking picture, it's beautiful. Why is that? Because the light conditions are good. But if you have a DSLR camera and you have a really bad lighting condition, you can fix it. You can fix it or in the DSLR, so in the camera itself, or in post-production. Thing is, if you have a phone and the condition is not good, you can also fix it in post-production. So MP, post-production. It's that simple. And what you need to keep in mind is when you're on the street out there, there's a lot of stories, especially between 6:30 and 9. It's called rush hour. During rush hour, a lot of things are happening. People go to work, people sell things. So during the rush hour, a lot of things happen. And also in the evening, when you look at 4 p.m. until, I think it was 7:30 or 6:30. Yeah, that's rush hour. Also, when people go home, people go do grocery or whatever, a lot of things happen. At this moment, you have the sunset in most country, and here before this you have the sunrise. It depends where you are. When you have the sunrise, people go to work, but it depends where you are, what time. A lot of things happen. What you can do is just grab your camera, walk outside, take pictures of everything. It can be from here until 9. You did your work, and then 10 you're gonna edit your picture, and then you can put them on stock. It's that simple. What I'm saying, during the rush hour, a lot of things happen and you can get stories. And with those stories, it's interesting because you can make a picture of the local business doing their business during the rush hour, or some people going to work, or some people coming from work in the evening. You understand? So these are the best moments to take street photography. Yeah? And most time on the street, you have a story. You just need to find one. Something that seems natural or normal for you can also be a story for someone else. Yeah? And don't try to make it perfect. Just go out there, take pictures, see what works, and how can you test if something works. Let's say if I go every day in a week, Monday until Sunday. So Monday until Sunday, I go out in the morning and in the evening. So close to the evening, I take pictures. So I have around, let's say 100 pictures a day. I say 100 because when you take picture, most of the time it's 500, and there's only 100 good pictures in it. You edit them, and then when you edit those pictures, so you have 700 pictures, you edit those pictures, you upload them to an agency. They choose which pictures they like, and based on that, they will distribute it to other places where they can sell. So you have in 1 week 700 pictures. You upload them to the agency, and then they distribute it to other agency or other platforms to sell those pictures. The nice thing about this is that some of them will have good stories, some of them don't. But 700 every week is a really good target, because it can help you get a clear idea, okay, which picture is selling and which not. You understand? After doing this for like 3 months, you know, okay, this is selling and it's not selling. It's as simple. Based on that, you know, okay, I'm going to focus on that. I'm going to focus on that. So street photography is a good way of finding out what works and what doesn't work and what can you sell. And just remember, if you take some pictures on the street of people, let them sign some model release. And you'll be like, okay, but I'm not going to walk with some paper and let people sign it. No, you don't have to. What you can do is, you have an app. If you take a picture of someone, you talk with them, let them sign, fill the information in it. Okay? And when they press send, you have a complete model release. And this, you can upload them on the platform. It's that simple. So photography can be a good business, right? And you can start out with it. If you don't have anything to do, just grab your phone, download the app, and start walking around. Just take some pictures, because during the rush hour is a good moment to take pictures, and you can find some story, and based on those things, it can help you. If you're a student, what you can do is not Saturday and Sunday, but let's say a day in the week when you're free, just go out there, take some pictures of people on the street, and then sell them on stock photography. That's how you can start. Street photography, you have a lot of stories there. So if you have questions about this, what you can do is just go here in the law center and ask me directly. I'm happy to help. If you have legal issue with copyright or other stuff, if you think about photography, feel free to join our legal session. It's free. During the legal session, I will try to help you and advise you as best as I could. And if you find this information useful and you can use it, just buy me some coffee, press this link, you arrive on this page. What you can do is you can support me by buying coffee, one coffee, three coffee, or five coffee, it's up to you. Or you can become a member. The benefits of the member, you'll find it below. And yeah, see you next video.
I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief. Know what I want, so I'll take it on. I've made mistakes, but mistakes make you strong. Let's break it down for a minute. I want the crown, I'm gon' get it. You hear me loud, man, I'm winning. Yeah, Charlie Sheen will be